You don't need gurus or prognosticators to be successful over your lifetime. One of the best ways to generate and protect wealth over long periods of time is to own a large number of businesses all around the world. Stocks are not just symbols on an account statement. They're not. You got Walt Disney and Amazon and Microsoft. You can go to Disneyland, right? Or Disney World in Florida, or watch a Disney DVD or buy a stuffed Mickey Mouse or something, right? It's a real company with real employees. You can go shopping on Amazon.com. All these people working for us, we own all these companies. Microsoft, you fire up your computer, you know that Microsoft is running your computer amongst all the other things that they do. In our portfolios, we own thousands of stocks all around the world. That means you and I own a small piece of thousands of businesses with millions of people working for us every single minute of every single day. Why would I want to sell that during a temporary downturn in the market? It's not easy to hang on to, but why would you want to sell that? These businesses are trying to make their customers happy. They're trying to create a profit for their company. Scott and I refer to that as a prudent, broadly diversified portfolio. That's what we refer to. So you got to learn how wealth is created. This is what Scott and I believe how wealth is created, not by some guru money manager. Population increases, economic freedom, knowledge and collaboration, and mutating technology. We touch on this in a whole class, but we're just going to just touch a little bit on mutating technology today. Mutating technology, it never stops. When a company takes one product or service with another product or service and combines it into something unimaginable to the original creator. Unimaginable. So even the simple toilet has been mutating recently. Check it out.
Hey.
Hi.
What's in the box?
The new toilet you ordered.
Oh, I didn't order that. Oh, that might be a present from my stupid son-in-law. That makes sense. He's put a lot of miles on our toilet.
Well, he must like you. It's one of those fancy Japanese electric deals.
Oh. Oh, no, don't be afraid. This is Tomo. Tomo, this is Joni. Joni.
Must everything be robotic? Please get this out of the house before it drowns us all.
But this was a thank you gift from Tim and Heather. It took me 5 hours to sync up our phones.
You gave this my number? I don't want a toilet calling me.
Oh, she won't. But she will warm your butt cheeks while she's reading you a book. Emma, hop on. She's on the second chapter of Mockingjay.
I will not hop on. You know how I feel about peeing on something with a name.
Oh, come on, Joni. Give Tomo a chance. Just one little tinkle. That's all I ask.
I tinkle on my terms.
Oh. I'm sorry, Tomo. She'll come around.
Hey, you ordered those bobbleheads of our family as a thank you gift for my parents, right?
Yeah, I worked really hard on the one for your dad. I'm sorry, Mr. Short, but I'm sure he's going to hate it just like he hates me. No, I can't hold anymore. When I buy myself a $2,000 Japanese toilet, you'd think they'd have better customer service.
You spend $2,000 on a toilet?
Well, yeah, people spend half their lives on the toilet.
No, babe, that's just you.
Oh! Oh, no. Is that Vivaldi?
Hey, I just got off the phone with the delivery company, and they said my toilet was shipped here.
Duh. I already thanked you for that. In fact, I just got off a 30-minute wash and wax. Woo.
Oh, no, John, that toilet wasn't meant...
John, I just tried the super toilet. And you were right. I feel warm, and I feel loved in a way that nobody's ever loved me.
Okay. Mutating technology. So the road to avoiding the scams, the fraud, and the shenanigans, both legal and illegal, we covered most of the legal ones today, is very narrow. You gotta stick to the basics, stick to the fundamentals, and use a third-party custodian to be able to verify your funds. And again, we covered these at the beginning, but these are our basics, these are our fundamentals. Easy to say, extremely hard to do over long periods of time.